HelloReviews.org, friends, families, and all you other Disney-loving strangers out there on the internet. I am Samantha, and I am so excited to be here today to share with you my review application for Reviews.org Disney+DreamJob. Like many of the other applicants, I've had trouble narrowing it down to just one favorite Disney film to talk about. But I have finally settled on Atlantis, The Lost Empire. So as part of my review, I have created an elaborate system in order to better judge films. By elaborate system, I mean I'm going to judge it on four different aspects and rank them on a scale of 1 to 10. So not really that elaborate. But my areas of interest today are going to be plot, characters, music, and writing or dialogue. So here we go. Atlantis came out in 2001, which puts it firmly in what I lovingly refer to as Disney's weird period. I think it's technically the beginning of the post-Renaissance era, but from the late 90s to early 2000s, there were some different movies coming out of the studio. I'd say weird in the best way possible. I think they were trying out different types of comedy, art, and storytelling. All that said, though, I would argue that Atlantis is one of the more normal movies out of the weird period. It's very traditional hero's journey. You have possibly one of the greatest calls to adventure ever. Who doesn't want an awesome buff woman sneaking into your house and packing up all your belongings to tell you that a millionaire wants to fund your expedition to a set of presumably ruins that nobody knows if they exist? Plot twist, they're not just ruins, but if you haven't seen the movie, I'm gonna tell you to go fix that, because it's a great movie and it needs more love. So I'm a firm believer that movies fall into one of two categories. You have your movies that are driven by plot, and you have your movies that are driven by character. So while Atlantis has this very traditional, well thought out, easy to follow plot, the thing that really drives it as a movie, at least for me as a viewer, is the insane cast of characters that help Milo and Kida along their journey. So you've got Audrey, your feisty mechanic, sweet, perhaps the sweetest doctor who's ever doctored. Mole, well just, it's Mole, I don't know. Packard gives the greatest commentary ever. Vinny, because who doesn't need a giant paperclip every once in a while? Cookie, God bless Cookie, who doesn't know what lettuce is, even though he's the expedition's cook. But he does, thankfully, bring the four basic food groups with him: beans, bacon, whiskey, and lard. So somebody out there is going to be like, why are you talking about music if Atlantis is not a musical? Well, my friends, it's not. But it does have a bunch of scoring, and it also has a credits song, which I had to check when I decided to do this movie. I was like, every Disney movie has a credits song. Why doesn't Atlantis? It does. I just didn't remember it. But in any film, scoring was really important to create an extra sense of like what you should be feeling in this moment. In that way, I think the score for this movie is spot on. I think my favorite is section of music is the first time you see Atlantis. You get another big sense of sweeping grandeur, and I really like pieces of music like that. So on to the writing. I think a lot of my love for the dialogue for this film sort of comes across in my love for the characters, because I think the humor and the wittiness that's written in is what makes the characters so good and the film overall so interesting. But there are two moments of dialogue in particular that I want to bring up.
Attention, tonight's supper will be baked beans, musical program to follow. Who wrote this?
Ba-dum-tsh. Yeah, I don't know. I don't have anything to add to it. It's just great. The other line that I want to bring up is near the end of the film. So, spoilers. If you haven't seen it, stop now. Watch it, then come back. So, when they're loading up the sort of crystallized Kida onto the trucks to take her back to civilization, and sell her to a museum. Rourke, sort of under his breath, says,
P.T. Barnum was right.
And I just, whoever out there wrote that and got it into the movie, thank you. Keep doing good. Well, I think we've pretty much hit all my big points. Again, if you haven't seen Atlantis, do yourself a favor and go see it. But now I'm going to give you my grand total for my intricate review system. So, for plot, because it's a very stable, traditional plot, I'm giving it a solid 7. It's not the most out of the ordinary, but it is exciting and keeps you entertained the whole time. Character-wise, I'm giving this movie a 10, because there's nobody in it that I don't like besides the villains who you're not supposed to like. And they're all crazy and very much their own people, which I think is great, especially when you've got such a big ensemble that you're playing with. So for music, I'm going to give it an 8. I don't know a ton about scoring films other than listening to film scores. So I think it does a really good job of helping the audience know what to feel, which can get a little bit heavy-handed, but I do also think that's the job of a film score. So I'm not mad about it. And I love a good, big, sweeping sense of excitement in music, and I think this film really does a great job conveying that, this film score. And then for writing, I'm going to give it a 9, because I think there's some really good one-liners, there's some really good jokes, callback jokes. The characters are, like I said, all really their own individual people, which I think can be difficult, and they do a great job of it. So, all combined with plot, character, music, and writing, I'm going to give Atlantis an 8.5 out of 10. I really hope I get the chance to do some more of these videos, put that incredibly intricate system to work again, and thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you real soon. Where the dream takes you.